Parents of children who claim to have had past lives, what did they tell you? So my mother doesn't believe in ghosts, reincarnation, etc, but she loves to tell this story from when I was 2 or 3. I'm 28 now. Apparently we were driving in the car, and I was chattering away like kids do. We were at a stoplight and all of a sudden, I stopped talking, squinted, and looked out the window. In a shaky voice, I said, "Why don't they ever come visit me?" My mother said it didn't sound like my voice, or a kid's for that matter. She asked who doesn't visit? My grandkids. They never visit anymore. Apparently it freaked my mom out. She tried to ask me later, that night and a few times, after what I was talking about, but I had no recollection of saying it all and still don't. I'm not the parent. This was my weird experience, but my mum still tells the story all the time. When I was about 4, we were driving through Scotland. I'd never been to Scotland in my life, and we stopped at this pub in a small village in the Cairngorms. I got out the car and said, "Oh, my favorite place," which my parents thought a bit weird, but sat down and got a drink, and my dad looked around and said, "Where are the toilets?" I apparently leapt up and took him by the hand straight to the toilets, which were actually tucked right away behind a fake wall type thing. Again, my parents were a bit unsettled, but just assumed I had seen them on the way in. But then it got weird. I was telling my mum about how much I used to love coming here and sitting beside the fire. There actually wasn't a fire in the pub, but also mum laughed and asked me what fire, and I pointed to wall and said that there used to be a fire over there. She shrugged it off, but then I carried on and went into more detail. I claimed I used to live out here and come in the pub nearly every day. I was friends with the owner, Fred. My mum went and spoke to one of the bar staff and asked if there was a man named Fred here, to which she replied, "Oh no, sorry miss, Fred died over 10 years ago now." My parents say it was one of the spookiest things. Obviously, maybe I had seen a sign, maybe I'd noticed the toilets when I walked in and seen a picture of the old fireplace on the wall. I don't remember, but I choose to believe I used to be an old farmer with a local pub up in Scotland. My little brother used to tell my mom and I that he died when he was 11 by being hit by a car. He said our mom was his mom before, and when he died she was crying at his headstone. He said this many times between when he could first talk till he was about 6 or so, so it wasn't a one-time thing. Always was 11, always by being hit by a car, it was always our mom crying at his headstone. We were super paranoid when he eventually did turn 11, but now he's 19 and has never been hit by a car or has died. Apparently, when I was just old enough to talk in sentences, I'd walk around the house and backyard with a large cloth bag that I found in my mum's closet. Mom asked me one day why I always wore the bag slung over my shoulder. I told her it was for delivering messages, like I did in China. This became a recurring theme, and I'd often mention little details about my past life in China. When my parents asked if I had a Chinese name, I'd say, "You can just call me Bob." My younger brother, 11 year difference, told me and my parents about his past life when he was very young, 4-5. He would describe the streets of India he lived in with great detail, and how he was crushed by an elephant. He would cry for a long period of time about how there was so much blood, and how he always became cold at the end of these memories. It sounds ridiculous, but he shared this story about how he died, so clearly without ever being exposed to death, or bleeding more than just a few scrapes, that it made me question a lot. Not past life, but along the same lines of weird things kids have come out with. When my oldest was nearly 3, we were driving through the city and he pointed out a factory and said, "Look mum, that's a chocolate factory," something he would have had no way of knowing. So I asked him how he knew that, and he told me the aliens told me that. Mum, okay, cool. Active imagination or something, right? Oh, when do you talk to aliens sometimes? When I can't sleep at night they pick me up. Worth mentioning here that he's always had severe issues dropping off to sleep, so much so he has professional help with it. Asked him what he does when he's with the aliens, and he told me usually they just get me to sit down and they ask me questions. Sometimes they get to do puzzles. If I'm good, I get to see the driver's seat and look at the buttons. The weirdest part is, he was never much of a talker back then. It's probably the most words he ever spoke in a sentence till he turned 4. My friend's little girl said to her family, when she was 2, "I came to Earth this time to see what it's like to be a human. And I love having hands. It's so great. And generally I think kids just say bizarre shit, but this kid is 5. But she really is weirdly wise and just, I can't explain it, but I saw her today and she seems like she knows much more than most people with regard to sensitivity and perception." This one really isn't about past lives, but my second youngest son had a weird little experience when he met his new stepdad's extended family. My husband and I were newly engaged and took my son, then 3, to celebrate Passover at my husband's, then fiancé, aunt's house. I got my son out of the car and he looked at the house in shock and shouted, "Mommy, mommy, this is where my family is. I knew I would get here someday. Before I even came out of your tummy, I'm really here." Then when we went in, he spent an extensive amount of time telling everyone that he had known, before he even came out of my tummy, that he would meet them here, and kept trying to remind me of this house. He would pick up random objects and say incredulously, "Mommy, look, even this. I saw it. I knew I would come here, where my family is, before I even came out of your tummy. And now I'm here." At one point he was lying on the floor in the guest bathroom saying, "Wow, even the bathroom, it's all the same. I knew it. It was bizarre." Random things my daughter has said and done have made me wonder. When she was 3, she would seemingly put herself in the lotus position and other meditative stances quite accurately, despite never being shown this. A year later she mentioned to me that she wished her skin color was brown again. She was very sad about missing it. When playing with stickers she always chose a little one to stick on her forehead and wear it all day. When her grandmother helped her choose a birthday gift for me, she made her drive all around town to find a sarong that had elephants on it. She's always been obsessed with elephants. All this when she was at an age where she hadn't been exposed to anything for her to parrot these things. My daughter was sitting next to the fireplace while I was using my blowtorch on the coals. She tilted her head and said she has been here before when she was a boy and that she couldn't get out of the fireplace. I was completely caught by surprise by it and asked her what she was talking about. She kept it repeating, "I don't remember, I don't remember." She was 4 at the time. Not a parent, but about my mom's friend's kid. So in some communities in India there is this belief that until you pierce a girl's ears she will remember her past life. It's nonsense, but a lot of people get their ears pierced early in life because of this. My mom's friend didn't believe in this stuff, so she never got her daughter's ears pierced. Anyway, her daughter was around 3 years old when the family decided to go out for a drive. She was really excited and telling her dad to drive near the woods instead of towards the city. It was the middle of the day, so he was like, "Sure." She kept chattering about the little house there and describing it, the dimensions of the place and the color, and she kept talking about this woman who was her mother or something. The details are really fuzzy to me now, I heard this many years ago. She kept saying something about it being very hot, and she was dancing, and that she couldn't remember. They basically dismissed it, until she said, "Oh, turn left here. The house is right here." And they turned, and they saw the house, except it was abandoned, and kind of burnt out. They went home, and looked it up and apparently a little girl died in that house, because it burned down. It's possible someone told her to play this prank, but she herself couldn't have found the house. It was far away enough that she couldn't have walked, plus she was 3, and not really allowed to go anywhere. My mom's friend was really shaken up. My best friend regularly babysits for the parents of a 4-year-old girl. On one occasion, she described in detail about how she remembered being separated from her mother and father, and how she was put in a dark and hot room with many other people and that's where they died. We thought she may have been talking about the Holocaust, but there is no way she would be able to even know about that at her age, let alone know about how people were killed during that time. On another occasion, she talked about how she remembered having a little sister and being outside with her parents when there was a big fire and her mother died. My friend and I looked this up and found results from the earlier 2000s or so about how a family with 2 young daughters were grilling outside when the propane tank exploded, killing the mother. As far as I know, she hasn't talked about anything else relating to those events, but it's still really creepy hearing it from a kid who has no idea that bad things even exist. When my youngest son was 3, we were driving through a part of town we don't often visit, and he pointed out a house. That's where my first mummy lived when I used to be a little girl. She wasn't nice to me. I was very scared of her. I'm glad you're my mummy now. Freaky. When I was a child, preschool aged, I used the wrong words for stop and come back. When asked about this, I told my parents a story about it being late at night, and I stood in a long line of people on a road that curved with the side of a hill. I was worried about my papers. I heard a gunshot and the people in uniforms checking papers came walking down the line yelling for me. I was a late 20s male and had a female partner. I took her hand so we could run for it down the hill. I remembered thinking I just need to make it to the river because of the dogs and we need to go now to have some distance before the men in uniforms get too close. We ran, the men in uniforms started yelling the words I used as a child for stop and come back. My partner tripped. I stopped for her, but the men were too close. We both turned face down. I remember thinking what a pitiful attempt to hide in the grass. They saw us and are right behind us, but we didn't have another option. I crawled on top of her to protect her as best I could with my back to the men in uniforms. I remember hoping they would only beat me, but knew that wasn't going to happen. There were two men chasing us, one closer than the other. They were only 20 steps behind or so, because as soon as she fell and I stopped to protect her, I heard their footsteps slow down. I closed my eyes, lost into the footsteps stop, heard a gunshot, everything went white, and I woke up as a child again with the thought it will be better this time. My parents asked around about the words I used. Turns out they were Czech. I still have a recurring dream about the line, running, being chased, her falling, me trying to protect her, and being shot in the back at close range at least once a year. I always wake up feeling the sting of being shot between the spine and the right shoulder blade. Not a parent or a child, so I guess irrelevant to OP, but I've had a crazy dream. The setting was around Nepal along the Himalayas. I was a monk, or something. Now I don't normally believe in past lives, or reincarnation for that matter, but this dream was the most real I have ever had. It was real, because I knew things about myself. Like memories within memories, right? I was religious. I knew what I looked like. The smell, heights, the village, I was all there before. Regardless, a storm was coming. It was apparently a massive snowstorm with incredible winds. I was tasked to bring in livestock and tie down anything which could blow away. I ran, fast, to my destination. I remember adrenaline and other feelings one would normally get in the midst of massive storm. Perhaps these feelings were just my brain remembering and inserting these feelings. On my way back I slipped and fell down the rocky face of the mountain. I remember looking up as I fell, seeing the top of the mountain I lived on turned red just like all my other surroundings. But I didn't wake up after the fall like most falling dreams. I smashed into each rock on my way down. Each hit left a perceived searing pain. Cracked ribs, broken leg, and so on. I blacked out after a hit into the skull, which I presume is when I died. I woke up, but my body remembered each hit that hurt the most. I didn't sleep after that, and I was shook the whole day. I just found the whole dream strange. The memories, the buildings, the feelings, and pain. I've never been to Asia. I only know what those buildings would look like from pictures, but none of those houses and buildings weren't like any I have ever seen before. So yeah, completely irrelevant to the question, but I had to share. This dream has not haunted me, but definitely made question my perception on my own reality. Not exactly a past life, but a creepy thing my daughter used to say. When she turned 2, she started talking about the big guy. We'd ask questions about him to humor her, assuming it was just our toddler being weird, as kids tend to be sometimes. He was always wearing a brown shirt, brown pants, and a brown hat. Our daughter loved the color blue, so it was a surprise to hear her describe anything as not blue, especially her least favorite color, brown. When we'd ask what the big guy was doing, he was always eating an apple. Sometimes he was outside our house, on the porch, or in our unfinished basement. Sometimes he was knocking on the front door. We used to joke that he must be a RUPS driver, wearing all that brown, and knocking on the front door. This talk of the big guy goes on for several months. One day, I took my daughter into town for the day. In the center of town is a war memorial. Every time we walk by the war memorial, she points above the WWI memorial, shouting, "The big guy, up in the sky." We walked by the memorial 7 to 8 times, while running various errands and just trying to kill time for the day, and every single time, she ran over to the WWI memorial, pointing up and taking about the big guy in the sky. The last time we walked by, she told me that the silly big guy came down and walked with us down the street. She kept turning back and slyly giggling at seemingly nothing. Never heard about the big guy again after that day. Just created an account to reply to this. When I was at the end of grade 11, I had a very memorable dream that has stuck with me since. I'm 19 now. I was walking down a street with tall buildings on either side, and it was quite dark and the ground was wet, like it had just rained all the while I was looking down at the ground. I came to a crosswalk with an overhead street light, and looked up to see a pair of headlights come right at me. Next thing I knew, I was on the ground and everything went white, and I had a warm tingling sensation come over me, somewhat like when your foot falls asleep, but it's your whole body and there was no pain. Right after I got hit, I thought to myself, did I just die? Then I woke up. However, I still had the warm tingling sensation, and I know my vision just went white. It's incredibly hard to explain, but now every time I think back to that dream, I get a chill through my whole body and tears well up uncontrollably without being me being sad at the time. It's something that I haven't really told anyone about, just because how crazy it sounds, and I'm glad I can post it somewhere. If you have any questions, I can try to answer them.